So, coming towards the end of the track. No one told us this, but it gets bloody steep. How are we doing, Greg?
Fucked.
After a few false starts, we managed to get a sends on the Abel Tasman track. We've got our lives on our backs. We've got 3.5 hours of this. This is looking pretty epic already. The river is deep, there'll be some fishes in it.
Get tackle
out. Get tackle out. Now, tackle won't be coming out for a bit, lad. Onwards and upwards. First stop, got brew on. Just having a little rest, about 2 hours in. Quite a nice walk so far. Pretty easy.
We are on hour number 4. We're just closing in on our first campsite. The view is pretty spectacular. Day 1 completed.
Greg, get it out! Greg's not going to be happy with me. Persuaded him to wade through the river, thinking we could get across. But no, far too deep.
Love it. How beautiful this water is.
Wow. That'd be right, swim.
Get in.
Get in.
Already been.
What the fuck I was going to say?
So here we are at Anchorage Bay campsite. Got a few mussels for tea. Say a few, we got bloody loads.
We are on day 2 of the Abel Tasman walk. Feeling pretty fresh this morning, had a nice breakfast.
So after Todd was mocking me, you know, trying to cross the bridge yesterday, Todd just tried to cross this little stream and went flying face first into it. We can still see the campsites there. I'm very, very sad right now that I did not film that because it was one of the greatest things I've ever seen.
Bag sodden, clothes sodden, bees around me, feet are sodden.
This was the low tide trek. You can see now that we missed the low tide off because we were too busy having a really big breakfast.
Bag off his back, loving life. We're on Torrent Bay. We've been stared at by some fishermen in this boat here. Yeah, we're just gonna have a spot of lunch. Quite hard that walk, wasn't it, Greg? Yeah, lack of sleep after the first day. And this guy's still having a little look. I'm gonna say hello.
Hello.
So, we've just been out on a little trip on a boat. Offered to give a helping hand to a man whose boat was stuck on the sand. And yeah, he offered to take us out to go and collect his cray boxes. So we went out onto the sea. Got a shitload of fish, as you can see there. We also fucking got a shark, which was huge, absolutely huge, but we had to leave out there for various reasons. I think the highlight of the little outing was Greg hauling in a crayfish box, which we didn't manage to get on camera.
This is campsite number 2 of the Abel Tasman walk, Bark Bay. Yeah, the water is like crazy blue. Gonna put a tent up nice and quickly and go for a little swim, I think.
Day 3. Just had a nice sleep at Bark Bay campsite, which we're just leaving now. Full of bees. Good toilets. No shower, but that's all we needed, really.
We've got 4 hours and 30 minutes to the next camp. It's the longest walk so far, but there is a pub at the end of it, and that's what's motivating me right now. Get some beer at the end of it. I'm waiting for my pint. I think that's the main motivation today. Get in there, get in beer.
We're feeling good, feet are repaired, and we're marching through the forest now.
Hour down, 3 hours to go.
Woo! Go on, baby!
So just had a lovely little lunch stop, me and our Greg. Caught some mussels last night, but we weren't really allowed to catch seafood at this bay, so we brought our own in a lovely little handmade mussel pouch out of old milk carton. Foiled inside, perfect. We don't fuck about. So we're just walking along Tonga Bay. You can see Tonga Island in the background there. Looks like it's high tide, so we might get stuck again. After the dramatic fall I had this morning. Oh, it was a bad fall.
So, Here we are at the end of the Abel Tasman walk. We managed to find a bar, but I think they more wanted kind of the nice posh glampers coming in. There was like a new track involved that involved going up the side of a mountain. But we just sat here now, found a little pizza bar.
There's a cafe and a pizzeria.
Yeah.
Lovely, a German and a
Dutch
person.
Yeah.
Made amazing pizza, and we got a couple of bits.
Couple of beeps. But it's been a really good. it's been a really good walk. I've really enjoyed it. I think it's kind of summed up New Zealand for me as well. It kind of said like, when you kind of like. You're walking through loads of bush for ages, so walking through loads of trees and bushes, and then you're like, fucking hell, this place is a bit weird. It's kind of a bit strange. Mm-hmm. But then you turn a corner and you're like, oh, shit. Wow.